Got the old music today.
Brought it back, huh?
Just a little bit. You know, you got to switch it up on them every once in a while. Thanks to Philly slang out there.
Can't catch them. Can't let
watching playoff hockey right now, overtime. Some bullshit.
If the Bruins lose, it's going to be a different mood up in here. Peace to Vega.
He's
sliding through on a shitty Sunday evening.
It is rainy out there today.
We've been getting hit with the torrential weather the past about a week or so here in the greater New England area.
It's bullshit. How you doing, man?
I'm doing all right, man. I can't lie to you. I'm doing okay.
That's what's up.
Could be a lot worse, man. How about yourself?
Doing good.
I see you sliding through with that ill shirt right there. Was that Jason Voorhees with a samurai sword?
Oh, yeah.
What?
Hung out with Harmon yesterday. We went played some pinball.
Oh, you went up north?
Yeah. Well, it's kind of what's south for me.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. How many? Explain to the people what the place is at. What it's all about.
I'm a member of the Southern New Hampshire Pinball Club, and it is a club that has, I'm going to say, like 40 to 50 pinball machines.
That is wild. Wait a minute. How big of a space is this? That's a lot.
It's a pretty big space. It's in a warehouse, like in a residential neighborhood. It's bizarre. You know, it looks like, when I brought Harmon there, he's like, yo, what the fuck is this? He's like, I feel like I'm about to be murdered down
yeah,
there.
Yeah, for real.
And then you put in the passcode, you get up in there, and it's fucking just lovely. Just tons of pinball machines. They got some good ones up in there. Terminator 2, The Avengers, Metallica, amongst others. All free play.
I have a lot of questions.
Bring your own beer. They have two fridges stocked full of beer.
Are the machines free to play?
Yes.
Oh, they are?
All free, yeah.
Oh, wow.
It's part of being a member, yeah.
Wow, how long have you been a member of this club?
Since like December.
And is anybody allowed to join? Well, like you got to like...
Anyone's allowed to join.
You got to be like a Mexican from like Boston. No,
this is like the best club ever. I mean, this is better than any kind of fucking Legion or fucking any of that shit. This place is incredible. It's the best. I go there all the time. No one's ever been there when I've been gone.
You're always by yourself?
I'm like always by myself. Unless Harmon meets me there.
Or like... Do they just, like, have the things running all the time, or do you, like, go in and...
I turn them on.
Oh, man.
We got TVs in there. Me and Harmon watching the games while we're freaking watching the Celtics while we got the playing pinball.
I'm about to take a day off.
I'm telling you, man, come through one night. Well, you don't even need to take a day off because I have 24/7 hour access, man.
Yeah, but you have to work, too. You know what I mean?
So,
I
don't sleep. You know this. I'm here right now on a Sunday night. I got to work tomorrow morning.
Sunday evening. Fucking Bruins are keeping us up. Yeah. We would have started an hour ago.
We would have. It's going to be a short show. Luckily, we know what we're talking about tonight. We got a special show lined up for you. It's a special anniversary from one of our favorite films, Blood In, Blood Out. We'll be talking about that later. Jelani.
I really want to just like do a scene-by-scene recap, but we don't have time for that, unfortunately.
That's way too much.
But I would love to tell you about why I love every single thing about this movie.
Some news. You want to hear some news?
I do.
All right, here we go. You hear about Pras from the Fugees?
Yeah, I did. I became familiar with this a couple of weeks ago. I think I sent it in the group about the whole situation and why I thought it was really weird that Pras was getting really thrown to the wolves while other people weren't.
That's kind of strange, right? That is a little strange. It still sucks, though, you know, because, you know, Pras done fucked up. He's been found guilty on 10 counts of international fraud, which can't be good. Leonardo DiCaprio was a witness? He's dropping dimes? I don't know what the hell is going on.
Because Leo was in cahoots with this dude also and bringing him around, always hanging out, partying with him also. I think Leo, I don't know the man business, but I think he turned states.
Think so?
I think they flipped him.
Flipped him for real, huh?
They're like, we got shit on you too.
He was like, I'll talk.
He's like, yeah, Pras who? He's like, what's a Fuji? He sang like Lauryn Hill in that motherfucker.
But then a couple years ago, you had Wyclef fucking around too. With that Haiti buddy. Remember that shit?
I don't know if I recall that.
He there was like some big earthquake in Haiti, and so he held like a fundraiser, did all this shit to get dough up for Haiti. And then he never gave the money to Haiti. He just kept the money. It was like,
I don't believe that.
You don't believe that? I believe it.
I feel like he raises so much money for Haiti, and he does all these fundraisers, because Haiti gets hit with these earthquakes and all these natural disasters more so than I think any other tropical country.
He tried to do a Reddit a couple years ago, and he got fucking blasted. It lasted like 3 seconds. He asked me anything or whatever. Back in 2010, it was reported that criminal investigation had been opened into John's Haitian aid organization, Yelly Haiti, despite taking in around $16 million in donations in 2010. 2010 alone, the charity was closed 2 years later amid accusations of fraud. It was alleged that Yele spent $9 million of the $16 million on office space worker salaries and other expenses. It was also reported that Wyclef John paid himself $100,000 to perform in a charity concert for the organization.
Was the office workers, were those people paid that work for the foundation? Like, were they like on the ground? I have a lot of questions. I mean, this could be pretty legit for the most part, aside from him taking the money for the concert.
Yeah, that's whack.
That part, if it's your thing, you know, you should just work for free because you're trying to help the company.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know. I didn't remember that one.
Yeah, that's a good one.
That's not a good one. That's a bad one. That's tough. I mean, what, the Fugees down bad?
The Fugees is nice, yo.
They are, but hot damn. Who knew that Lauryn Hill would be the only one not in that legal trouble?
Right? It's wild, huh? It's wild out in these streets.
Peace to L Boogie. Peace to L Boog.
What else do we got here?
Man, but yeah, if everybody else, I don't know all the ins and outs, but the situation with that one is there was this like big, you know, wealthy dude that they were all hanging out with, but he was a flim flam man. He was lying and stealing all this money.
Flim flamming.
And because he was so wealthy, everybody wanted to hang out with him. All the celebrities are like, oh, this dude's got fucking boats and jets and going everywhere. You know, let's hang out with this guy. He's buying everything, comping everything. But the guy's a con artist. And in the process of him stealing all this money and being all flashy and whatnot, he's getting all these other people to like endorse him and like help him get all these other, you know, people, influential people around him. And
it's some Firefest shit, but just different.
DiCaprio was with him a lot, is what the paper said.
Yeah, they're chilling.
And Pras is going to prison.
Jesus Christ. This poor bastard.
Everybody want to be a nigga till police cover out.
Are you familiar with Desiigner?
The rapper?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not familiar with his music, but he's been in the news recently. He's been charged with indecent exposure. Desiigner. Do I?
He was Panda. Panda, Panda, Panda.
I got you now.
He was Timmy Turner.
Okay.
That Timmy Turner was some hard shit.
He's been charged with indecent exposure on a plane.
Oh, Lord, no.
The rapper said he was ashamed in a statement. Desiigner's been charged with indecent exposure following his alleged actions on a plane. The rapper, whose real name is Sidney Royal Selby III, allegedly exposed himself and masturbated in front of a flight attendant on a journey from Tokyo to Minneapolis.
Yo, what?
On April 17th, according to a criminal complaint. If convicted, he could spend up to 90 days in prison. He addressed the statement, "For the past few months, I've not been okay, and I've been struggling to come to terms with what is going on. While overseers for a concert I performed at, I had to be admitted into a hospital. I was not thinking clearly. They gave me meds, and I had to hop on a plane home. I am ashamed of my actions that happened on that plane. I landed back into the States and admitted myself into a facility to help me. I will be canceling all of my shows and any obligations until further notice. Mental health is real, guys. Please pray for me. If you're not feeling like yourself, please get help."
You know what? I wish him well.
As do I.
Because that is some real weirdo shit to be doing.
You can't be in your right state of mind when you're doing something like that.
There's no way in public. You're old enough to know better. So I really, I don't know. I hate to you know, blame the victim. But I'm not really. I'm just saying this guy might really have.
Maybe he was watching that Ric Flair documentary and he was like,
he got
inspired.
The Nature Boy did it.
Wasn't that? No, that was from like Russia or something like that to some place, right?
Yeah, they were coming back from somewhere in Europe and unfortunately accosted the flight crew.
Or was it North Korea?
They were in North Korea, but that wasn't that one. The North Korea one, they had to flee for their lives because they were getting followed everywhere they went. That was also awesome.
Jesus Christ, we wrestlers have the craziest fucking stories, bro.
Yeah, Desiigner had Panda, but then he had there was another one that Kanye used for one of his albums. It was pretty good. I don't know, but he was kind of flash in the pan. He was there and there and gone. That Timmy Turner was my shit though.
Yeah, some bugged out shit though, man.
Hope he's okay.
Yeah, man. That's some crazy shit.
I'm sorry for everybody involved.
Everybody. What else we got here for you?
Yeah, hit me with the news. News corner.
Yeah, I mean, you, and especially on a plane and shit too. That is like some wild and crazy shit.
Yeah, but look, nowadays, man,
people do wild since and crazy COVID, shit all the
time. People are just acting the ass on an airplane. There is no proper decorum from anybody anymore. Like it is far from the days when people would wear, you know, a suit and tie to get on an airplane. Now people just go on there and just act a fucking fool.
Benny the Butcher is going to be dropping a new album.
Word?
On Def Jam. It's called Everybody Can't Go. We'll have production from The Alchemist and Hit-Boy. And it's dropping on 8/11. So mark your calendar there, my friend. I'm excited.
8/11.
As a Benny Butcher fan. August?
Fucking 3.5 months from now.
Yeah, you know, you gotta be working on this shit, man.
Mark my calendar.
Mark your calendar.
Goodness gracious. I mean, I'm very happy to hear so, mm-hmm. But it was too early for me to be getting all, you know.
There's too much stuff, right?
If you tell me I have to remember this in 3 months.
Never going to remember.
Well, we keep getting hit over the head. Like, I this past week, I jumped back into that Larry June.
Oh, yeah, that's a fucking solid album, huh?
And it was kind of accidentally. Because I just opened up like Apple Music, which I haven't used in like a week or so.
Yep.
And it was just playing on there. And I was like, fuck, I opened this for something else, but I don't want to turn this off. So I just had to let the rest of the album play.
Yep.
It's that good. That dude.
He's that dude.
Al.
Alchemist is fucking crazy, man. Speaking of which, on a couple days ago, last week, Conway sat down with DJ Wackademics there.
Really?
And they were talking about Benny the Butcher and Freddie Gibbs. And Conway said, it's a messed up situation for me personally. That dude Gibbs, that's my dude. And he's like, I wish that shit never happened. I'd love to squash that. I wish I could have. If I was there, I don't know what could have happened. I'm talking about none of it.
Yeah,
the shit they talking about. I'm talking about all the shit before and all that. I just wish that shit never happened. But he wants to kind of have a sit down with them, I think, and try to squash their shit. I was listening to that Benny the Butcher and Freddie Gibbs song. I forget which one it was, but man, it was fucking great.
It was
great,
amazing. Together. Yeah, everyone's just lost. Who knows what could have been.
This is some bullshit. Yeah. Who with knows? The Bruins, you mean? The Bruins?
I don't even want to talk about it. I just want to let you
close
know.
This TV right
now? Yeah, no, I'm closing the app altogether. Who knows what could have been? Because, yes, the music that they had already done together was already fucking flames. So it's like, why should, if this could bubble, if these dudes could, you know, somehow reconcile and do an album together, that would just be amazing. And yeah, I don't know exactly what the whole situation was, but I think it's too late now.
Yeah, I know that. Didn't Benny steal his chain?
The chain was stolen. I do recall that vividly. Oh, man, what a bummer. What a bummer. Speaking of Conway, he just put out a new track the other day.
Yeah, I think we played it. Was it last week?
Oh, I thought it just came out the other day. Or maybe just the video came out the other day.
He's got a couple, yeah. The one on the west side?
No, it was Jay Skies, maybe? Boop, 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 boop. Yeah, so much music. So hard to, you know, keep track of all of it.
Okay.
But yeah, everybody out here working. And I love that for us.
Let me play quick. What you got? What you saying?
Go ahead.
So let me play a quick one for you, and then we'll get into that Conway you sent me.
Let's do it all.
Let's do it all. I've been listening to this on repeat. I don't know why I love this song. I'm not sure if we played it on the show before, but I'll play it again here now.
What we got?
All right, here we go. I'm over here now. Hold on a second.
Are you, though?
Yeah, I'm over here. I'm over here now.
Don't go patting yourself on the back now, Barry Horowitz.
Yeah. Yo, what goes around comes around. That's why I got the car and Chevy rat. The illest shit I seen in my life was in the feds. Drew J. Joggers gauge down the fucking leg. Whipping Yola looking like I'm cooking fucking eggs. Half my niggas doing like my other niggas dead. Rock the vintage iceberg with the Snoopy hat. Bobby Fischer in the Fisker, you know the richer. Muzzle on the baby tech, you can hear the bullets whisper. My pockets got more sauce than a shot steak. New York my state, check the Buffalo crime rate. Gas up on the hip, case you niggas trip. I run up on your whip and do some more gangland shit. On the rail, niggas know the deal. Call like a field bucket on sugar hill. Niggas getting money, everybody worth a mil. Wipe my ass with a new $100 bill, for real. Yeah, 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 yeah. Half my niggas doing like my other, niggas dead. Yeah, you can hear the bullets whisper. Grows around, comes around. Check, 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 check the buck.
The fuck? What was the outro?
West Side's on some other shit. I think it was from that.
Did that on purpose.
Remember that? The Boss N Word movie. Remember that one?
Oh my gosh, I do.
Maybe that's what that's from. I think.
I do remember that movie. That's weird. That's why y'all need fucking CRT in this country. Y'all need to learn today.
That's right. All right, we can get to that Conway one.
We'll talk about what else we got for new music.
Oh, yeah.
They want to know what I got on the wrist, cost me plying to get it off me. This ain't water, this shit coffee. Brownstones, bitch, this the Cosby's. A nigga still sliding with sticks like Sid Crosby. I used to flip doggy. Got on my hip, I live for me. If niggas get froggy, told the record label you got 48 hours like Nick Nolte to restructure the deal. Them numbers only insult me. They sent satellites to space and a trace of intelligent life and they came across me. Niggas gonna be pouring out douce if niggas double cross me. The wrist frosty. To give godly, y'all crisscross to me. Y'all little niggas got it backwards. Bro, do the stepping and he not a capper. Push the black and yellow Maybach, niggas thinking I was capper. It's not a rapper that I fear, you niggas not a factor. Yeah. I cross my T's, dotted my I's. Rap niggas still struggle to eat, I'm not surprised. Look, I got it out of the streets and I survived. Third degree, that's from all of the heat that I provide. Look, I make them softy motherfuckers uncomfortable. Cause when they see that dog in your heart, they wanna muzzle you. And Weez used to tell me them niggas is drinking honey proof, thinking that they can fuck with you. So give them more lines and see a sucker suit. Machine indestructible, the same brownstones. Got my bitch looking like a young Claire Huxtable. They say machine, it ain't fair if niggas did fuck with you. It's clear cut that you the king, nigga. Yeah. Machine lead the team, I'm running up the scene, nigga. It's like Michael Thomas and Breeze, nigga. I took this dope shit, moved blocks, I had to sell it like a screen, nigga. Opened up the lead, but we still running these flea flickers.
Skip, they look really good, Skip. You had to be impressed with what you saw. I know you like this, Skip.
Look, I'm Slim Reaper when I hit speakers. Running for the full first 48 minutes like I don't get breathers. I hit the gym and I suspend leisure. Finna be 100 MC, a new champs, the drum sweat leaders. And we ain't even break a sweat neither. My scoring numbers reflect this was my best season. You ain't do enough work in the gym, your chest weaker. I'm Euro stepping to the rack, got the city on my back, homie.
I drop 40, still patting up my stats, homie. Deadly as Kobe or Kyrie up in the mask, homie. I got it on lock, it's automatic like I had the max on me. Tell for I'm teed in my bag, homie. I'm in the lead with the most MVP votes. I'm King James, how I dominated the East Coast. And when it's all said and done, at least two statistical categories, I'm a lead vote. Machine ghost.
Mm-hmm. Tell the truth, Gil. Go ahead, say.
My turn?
No. Oh. You can say you like. Not if you like.
I like.
We hold it down east to west on both coasts. It's facts undisputed, we ain't moving no goalposts. I'm money from the three or the low post. I cook them on slow roast. The other side really want no smoke. Yeah. We hold it down east to west on both coasts. It's facts undisputed, we ain't moving no goalposts. I'm money from the three or the low post. I cook them on slow roast. The other side really want no smoke.
Not a bad one right there, huh?
Yo, they were spitting on that one.
Yeah, they little cook at the end there.
Yeah, I appreciate that one.
You're talking about new music. You want to know what's out right now?
Yeah,
that might
sure.
Be, that you might need to get on your radar here.
Maybe I got something you might need to get on your radar.
Oh, shit.
Bro. Okay.
All right, there's a couple things.
Okay, hit me.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Do you listen to the new Jack Harlow?
No, I have not. I'm sorry.
Don't fucking lie to me.
I didn't mean. No, I have not.
All right, good. Neither did I.
I didn't know there was a new Jack Harlow.
Yeah, there was some. He was like, he said he was the hardest white dude since Eminem.
I saw that floating around, and I just figured people would just laugh at that. And keep it moving.
I didn't know he was a comedian too.
I mean, he must be promoting the new movie.
Yeah, the hardest white boy out. I think it's called, right? Right, here
on. Oh, no, yeah, because he has a new album out, and he has that White Man Can't Jump movie coming out.
Coming out soon, yeah.
Yeah, I think that's not too long, like a week or two away.
All right, for us,
mm-hmm.
Stuff that should be on our radar.
Okay.
Ill Bill dropped a new album called Billy.
Ooh, I've heard a track or two off of this one.
Fucking fire, bro.
Dynamite.
Like, wow, Billy's back.
Oh, some creepy ass videos too.
He's got Cool G Rap on there, Immortal Technique, Paz, Nems, Ritz, Tragedy Gaddafi. Our boy Ritz is on.
Come on,
there.
Fucking Ritz is back.
Tragedy Gaddafi, Ransom, and many more. Then you got Adrian Young and Ali Shaheed Muhammad got one out.
Ritz should fight Jack Harlow for saying that shit.
Boom, right there.
Ritz, how dare you?
Come on, Ritz can spit, dude.
He would eat Jack Harlow up. Anyway, sorry.
I was saying, what did I say? Adrian Young and Ali Sheedy Mohammed. Mm-hmm. They got some jazz joint out, I believe.
I believe it's actually Jazz History Month.
There you go. Boom.
So that is one I will definitely put on my radar.
Yeah, that could be good. Flea Lord and Crisis got one out called the 2-3 Zone.
A whole album.
This one features Bun B.
Flea Lord and Crisis?
Flea Lord and Crisis.
Crisis doing the whole thing? Oh.
Not that Crisis. Not the K.
Not K-R-Y?
C-R-I-S-I-S. Oh, okay. Not the Crisis. This one features Bun B, Conway the Machine, Trey the Truth, 38 Spesh, and others, yeah.
Well.
Young Morpheus got one out.
Homie.
Featuring Fly Anakin, Med, and others.
Yeah, did Fly Anakin drop a new one recently also?
He may have. He's always on some shit there. And
I'm a big fan.
Crime Apple got another one out. And Daniel Sun's on that one.
Man, this is so much.
It's a lot. I mean, and that's just stuff that we're interested in. I mean, there's so much other stuff here.
Yeah, for instance, maybe something that you're not interested in, but Swiss Beats dropped a new album. I listened to it. It was only 6 tracks, so it wasn't that big of a chore.
Okay, and I mean. In and out there?
Yeah, but a lot of features.
Good?
I'd say about 4 out of the 6 songs are really good.
Wait, there's more. Dave East got one out called The Book of David. Mm. There's some EPs that came out. So here, the EPs, you got... anybody? Oh, God Fahim and Mike Shab called Dump God Rhyme Pays.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Hell Rel, the Golden Triangle 3. I didn't know Hell Rel was still doing it like that.
Ruga Rel, baby.
Come on. Yeah, a lot of stuff, huh? I got to play something from that Ill Bill, though, huh?
Hell Rel. Yeah, that's the two or three songs that I've heard off of that one. Did we mention the Lloyd Banks that came out?
Yeah, you did last
week. Okay, that was last week that came out.
Last week you talked about it.
That was fun. I was listening to that much of the week. Yeah, from what I've heard of that Lloyd Banks joint, from the Ill Bill, like the two or three songs, ferocious.
All right, you want to hear some? Of course you do. All right, here we go.
We're over here.
I was in the projects in my Jordan 3s. 88 caught my first pair of Jordan 3s. Back then you got for your Jordan 3s. Either shoot or get shot for your Jordan 3s. I was in the projects in my Jordan 3s. 88 caught my first pair of Jordan 3s. Black cement, Nike Air, logo Jordan 3s. Camouflage, army shorts, and some Jordan 3s. Beat the plot of any Saturday, Kung Fu matinee. Grandmaster betrayed with a smile over champagne. Toast with a snake tongue, front to hide your hate. Night behind your back, student turned to rival of the great. Cain and Abel situations off the Bible page. Brother backstab his own brother in the primal praise. Fuck out the way my llama spray like a tidal wave. Pistols crack up the pop, the same sound that the final make. Probably an idiot and no man am I afraid. Suicidal tendencies with homicidal traits. Knives and blades slice your face when you collide with apes. Your empire in flames, the fire rage, homie die in pain. Died thousand deaths, resurrected and killed again and again. Empty your clip of 10 in your head. Russian mafia, your belly, Billy Bates, eating spray. In graffiti, lyrics and subway trains racing through the city. Glass seed envelopes, chemicals to cut the dope. Bulletproof vest, a box cutter to cut your throat. Shot in the head, big bong in the bubble coat. Sunk your motherfucking boat, slunk it with the pump and go. Boy George or a Brooklyn edition, cook in the kitchen. The brand you can trust, look at the pistol. Hustle the flip till we clutching the fistful. The gutters where we from, but fuck up, we made it blissful. I was in the projects in my Jordan 3s. 88 caught my first pair of Jordan 3s. Back then you got for your Jordan 3s. Either shoot or get shot for your Jordan 3s. I was in the projects in my Jordan 3s. 88 caught my first pair of Jordan 3s. Black cement, Nike Air, logo Jordan 3s. Let the plug know, I need another pair of 14s. Killers with blood diamonds in the dice, smiles behind barrels. My mind is a weapon, my darts are cyanide arrows. They wanna violate our freedom to the ninth power. Where you coop up with sacrifice to a blind owl. Blind justice, no policies to favor but sir. Lemons to lemonade, the angels into angel dust. Weed is legal in New York now, blaze it up. Right in front of a cop, is that shit strange or what? Native New Yorker though, I've traveled the globe. Shouts to all my goons in Amsterdam, Paris, and Rome. Tapped in the zone, open this artwork, I spit pain. Percussion is played to cut sharper than a switchblade. Supreme North Face Parker had some crisp chains. Goofy stepped on him, shot to six at the Knicks game. The fire aura glom the quarters like your father ordered. Like Dr. Fire himself was shot before the Pomodoro. I was in the projects in my Jordan 3s. 88 caught my first pair of Jordan 3s. Back then you got for your Jordan 3s. Either shoot or get shot for your Jordan 3s. I was in the projects in my Jordan 3s. 88 caught my first pair of Jordan 3s. Black cement, Nike Air, logo Jordan 3s. Let the plug know, I need another pair of 14s.
Yeah.
Shit's hard body right
now. Yo, it must have had some money in 83 to get your first pair of Jordan 3s.
Yeah. Bill was doing that thing. That thing.
People were selling livers for the get a pair of Jordans.
The best I had back in the day was like the Reebok pumps. I got them shits. I had the cross trainer joints. Teal. Black and teal.
Yeah, well, I wasn't really. I couldn't stunt on people like that back in the day.
Yeah, that was the only expensive pair of sneakers my mom ever got me. Every other time, it failed. I told you the story about that. I asked her for Charles Barkley, so like in '94.
Oh right? Man, that went horribly bad.
Yeah, that went real bad. She got me the Xavier McDaniels.
I like the X-Man as a player.
Yeah,
but the shoes weren't hitting like that.
No, but, it was bad.
But oddly enough, he came to our school when I was at the Breck, and I must have been in fifth or sixth grade.
The X-Man was there?
And he came, and like somehow we got one of, gave away his shoes.
Oh,
like,
shit.
My brother got one of them. And so like I had the X-Man's big ass fucking like size ET shoe in my house for the longest time.
Oh, that's amazing. Here, take these. They fucking stink as shit.
Yeah, take them. I think he took him off his feet. He's like, I'd rather be barefoot.
He's like that dude, who's Adam Sandler, the hairdresser there.
Yeah, I don't know.
You don't remember the Zohan.
Oh, yeah.
You ever seen that one?
No.
Oh, that was a good one.
I missed that one.
Yeah, that was funny. That was funny. That Ill Bill, man. He still got it.
I tell you.
Still got it.
Don't miss a beat.
Nope. Fucking great.
I can't wait to... how long is that album?
It's over an hour long, bro.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's like an hour and 10.
Wow. Ill Bill got back in the booth, huh?
Oh, yeah, he did.
Oh, man.
He's got a lot of features on there, but at the same time, he's got like 10 solo tracks at least, you know?
All right.
It's a lot, though, but it's really good. So it's like, I remember I was listening to it, and I got over halfway through, and I was like, oh, I can still keep going here. This is really good, you know?
Is it mostly like an upbeat album?
It is dark. It's pretty dark. It's okay. Like, you know, it's a...
Because remember, like, nonfiction stuff used to, like, you know, they used to have, like, slower beats, you know what I mean?
Yeah, no, he's got like some of those, like, he's got some of those, you know.
Thoughtful kind of songs.
Like, he's got some of those bangers on there.
I'm old now, man. I can't
Uncle Howie's on there.
Oh, God bless Uncle Howie.
Rest in peace, wow. Uncle Howie.
We used to watch that damn Uncle Howie video all the time.
Dude, the outtake, that whole thing, dude, that whole I Need Drugs fucking shit was crazy. Man, what a good time that was. He was, if you don't know who Uncle Howie is, look him up. He's just a legend. Holy mackerel. I'm sure you can find him on YouTube, whatever.
He lived a
him
life.
And him and his boy Mordecai there. Fucking wildin'.
And, you know, unfortunately, the people who are addicted to drugs, you find other people, you know, to help you, you know.
I think he got clean at the end, though. So I'm happy when he passed it, I hope that he was clean and, you know, all that good stuff. You know? He was a character. Holy mackerel, those videos are just legendary. Ill Bill, his label, Uncle Howie Records.
Uncle Howie Records.
Yeah. Amazing.
I still have the shirt around here somewhere.
Yeah. Go out and get that, everybody.
The I Need Drug shirt with the Uncle Howie Records on the back.
It's psychological.
Psychological Records. Man.
That shit's worth a grip now, you know.
Probably. Yeah. But it's all ripped up. And,
don't matter.
You know what I mean?
Don't matter. That's probably cool to a Necro fan now.
It's in rough shape.
Well, it's over 20 years old.
I'm in pretty rough shape, too.
Yeah, exactly. You got holes in you, too.
It's been a long life. you want to play that other Ill Bill track before we...
Yeah, I will. This one's called The Prophets of Doom, and it's featuring Sick Jackin and Immortal Technique.
I've heard of all of those people.
You've heard of those guys?
Yeah.
They're pretty good.
Yeah.
They're pretty, pretty, pretty good. Are you a Sick Jackin guy?
Hell yeah.
Yeah. He's nice with it.
Because that was a name that would always pop up on the just like features of people shit. Mm. And then after a while, I was like, oh no, I got to look into this guy's solo stuff.
Yeah. I think Lost Shadow's a big fan. Hope I'm not speaking out of turn, man.
B.C. third, forced to prevaricate. Grandpa's from Uruguay on some Spanish shit. Skinny mustache, feeling cold chilling. Play Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood with a few women. Live the block away till he caught a heart attack. I was young but old enough to know he's not coming back. My first experience into death. Ambulance, this lady died waiting on his front steps. And that's how I lost my first BFF. The Grim Reaper been creeping around here ever since. I learned at a very young age that everything could just change in one day. We could be 1 minute or a second away from the very last breath that we take. Fill these lungs in my chest with that medical kit. And yet fake the whole lifetime ago to see like yesterday. Listen. Young shooters running up the double bullet in the system. No justice, no peace. We at war with the beast. Feed him a death till everybody y'all are deceased. Generation X, my teachers all talk to the beat. Rescuing my intellect from the jaws of defeat. Listen. We could be
one minute or a second away from the very last breath that we take. Fill these lungs in my chest with that medical kit and get baked the whole lifetime ago. It seemed like yesterday we could be one minute or a second away from the very last breath that we take. Fill these lungs in my chest with that medical kit and get baked the whole lifetime ago. It seemed like yesterday. My grandpa died young, was part of the 28 Club. His bartender married my grams. My father then ran to the street. His story I couldn't make up. Went from Sinaloa to LA, the city of gangs. They say you can't stop a run from death, but really you can. First off, move out from where the killers go ham. They let off and shoot out where they push kilos to grams. They will put you in the fetal if they need you for the band. Fuck your plans for tomorrow, fuck your plans for the day. What you think is gonna happen right now can go away. Everybody gotta pay back the body that they used to hold a soul the moment that they lay. Yeah, I really think that odds are something you play. Gamble with your life, one day you won't get away. Promise you there's no time as you. Flowers when they homage you. Only if you honor your hermano, then the karma's cool. Shit, clean your mess up, you got time. There's no pressing on rewind. Get that stress up out your mind right now. La muerte on the prowl. Don't know where, don't know how, but we all go out. We could be one minute or a second away from the very last breath that we take. Fill these lungs in my chest with that medical kit and get baked the whole lifetime ago. It seemed like yesterday. We could be one minute or a second away from the very last breath that we take. Fill these lungs in my chest with that medical kit and get baked the whole lifetime ago. It seemed like yesterday.
I got stories, but they want bars. They want to see behind the curtain like the Wizard of Oz. Well, I got advice against the enemies to your cause, but you might have to hear line fracture a law. I don't wish them bad, but I don't wish them no good. Like I hope your car never break down in my hood. It's gentrified now, so you will be fine. But people get murdered in nice places all of the time, and everybody knows that, cause they finished my line. And these motherfuckers don't even rhyme. Shout to the people that were shot from behind. It feels different when you finish the climb. At the top, when you pick the knives out of your spine, you appreciate the lesson and the design, and you thank the ancestors and the divine. When you survive and continue to shine, I'm not gonna tell you how much time you have left. I'ma just tell you the clock is ticking. So appreciate what the fuck you have. Cause pretty soon, you ain't gonna have.
What a weird video, huh?
Wild.
It's like an animated video. Where you have all the rappers, Ill Bill, Sick Jackin, and Immortal Technique, all their heads are animated and photoshopped onto.
Hang on, before that, Sick Jackin, I thought fucking killed him.
Oh yeah, he really did.
Everybody did, but yeah, that's one of those features where it's like, damn.
You're like, oh shit, need to check this
I
guy
need to
out
tap
more.
Tap in a lot yep. more. But yeah, as you're saying, the video was just.
I saw
animated
Matrix,
faces.
Matrix falling down. I believe Black Hawk Down, perhaps a couple others on there. A lot of good films. Oh, Deer Hunter.
They Live.
They Live. Yeah, especially that one.
There was a lot of just like, you know, action movies from like the '80s, or not even necessarily action, just, you know, dramatic movies also. But I was trying to figure out the one where I believe it's during Sick Jackin's verse. Somebody uses somebody's intestines as a rope to jump out the window and
was
go
that,
into the
Ricky O.
I was trying to, I don't know. It looks so familiar. I'm like, I know I've seen this before, but I don't know from where.
Right.
But, very cool video. If y'all check that one out, what was the name of that track?
Something of Doom. Prophets of Doom.
Prophets of Doom. We should really, like, you know, let people know the names of the songs when we play them or after.
Yeah. Well, I did. I said it before.
I sure you did.
I did. Yeah.
We don't believe you. You need more people.
You need more people. Actually, Jelani, today's a big day. Today is the 30th anniversary of our favorite movie, Blood and Blood Out, Bound by Honor.
Orale, vato.
It came out
Bound by Honor
April 30th, 1993.
Oh my god. Oh my god. I am so old.
You're very old.
We had no business watching this movie.
No, so good.
We were way too young to be watching this movie.
What Blood and Blood Out is a movie about a half Mexican kid who has to move
half
in.
Mexican, half white.
Half Mexican, half white.
It makes a big difference here.
He's Chicano.
Okay.
But he identifies as Mexican. He's not, he doesn't, nothing about him is white except
but
for his
skin. But why does he identify as Mexican?
Because he hates his white father?
His white father was abusive to he and his mother.
Tried to beat the Mexican out of him.
He would literally try to beat the Mexican out of him.
Didn't
physically.
Work.
Physically.
Didn't work.
Nah.
He turned it on him.
As you might hear often, Miklo was white on the outside, but brown on the inside.
Yes.
To the bone.
To the bone.
Okay.
He gets sent to live with his aunt and uncle, who have two kids, two sons, a stepson, which is Cruz, who's the artist, and then Paco, who is the leader of the Vatos Locos gang.
El Gallo Negro.
El Gallo Negro, the Black Rooster. And the movie follows their three lives throughout probably like how many three decades, probably, you have to say?
By the time you get to the end of it, probably close to it, yeah.
At least 2 to 3 decades that you follow these this family around on the, what they're doing. And basically one event starts off a whole line of events for each of these people's rest of their lives.
See, I don't know if that's true, though.
You don't think so?
Because when the movie starts, they already have beef with Tres Puntos.
Yes, but...
So who knows what happens before that? You know what I mean?
We can get it.
Okay, no, no, all right, all right. You're right, you're right. Slow down.
Slow down. We're going to get there.
You're talking about a movie now. Come on.
We're going to get there.
I tell you, for real, like, every... I watch this movie more than I should, but, like, on my birthday, I always put it on in the morning before I start my day. I just have it all in the background.
It's a lovely ritual right there.
And when you have the chickens crowing.
Okay, so, as I'll tell Jelani, the one event sets off the rest of these guys' lives, in my opinion. All right? The main character, Miklo, to get into the gang, to be down with his cousins, he kind of like... is boasting like to, you know, fuck up the gang that's rolling up on their turf. And one night they catch the guys in an alley. Mm-hmm. They're tagging up their alley. And Miklo's talking real big. And he's like, yo, we got to do something. And he's like, yo, why don't you fucking do something, pussy? Like,
mind you, Miklo is fresh out.
He's
fresh there, like
he's there for like 2 days. He just got his ass whooped by his dad. Just there, right? Yeah, yeah.
Just moved there, and he's like, "Nah, Holmes.
This is like the first night.
We can't let them disrespect us like this, Holmes."
Yeah. Oh, what you gonna do?
And Paco was like, "Yeah, you're so tough." Okay, go ahead. Start.
Boom. So Miklo grabs this like exhaust pipe, right, and then rolls up on these dudes who are spray painting their turf. Rolls up behind their ride and just bashes the back window, gives them the bird, and then screams Vatos Locos at them, and then they take off, right? Amazing. Amazing.
Awesome
way.
Stuff.
It's incredible.
They end up getting away because, you know, Paco, who we haven't mentioned yet, is played by Benjamin Bratt.
Benjamin Bratt.
A young Benjamin Bratt.
Miklo's played by, is it Daniel Ciampa, who is Ken in the Street Fighter movie?
He was. He absolutely was. But yeah, just a great strategic way to get the hell out of there. Just block the car.
Yeah.
I don't know why Tres Puntos didn't get out and just move the barrel, but you know, it's fine.
They didn't want to mess up the bumper,
Necro makes up.
Lift up the bumper like your uppercut. Like
your uppercut. Oh, we'll get into that racism later.
Your uppercut.
So, yeah, they just got one over on Tres Puntos.
Yeah, the rival gang. They're like, yeah, fuck you. And then, you know, they get away. It's a great time. The next day, or seemingly, you know, a day or two later, your boy Cruzito, the artist, he's getting honored at, like, I don't know, some, like, art thing. All right? And they give him a scholarship to go to art school. And he's, like, all fired. Maybe, is it art school? or is it another local school?
No, I think it is an art school because they're showcasing a bunch of his like paintings and whatnot, or like he, you know, graduated high in his class or something like that.
Yeah.
And like the whole family's there, they're all proud of him. Yeah,
they're very proud. He's the first of the family to graduate high school. Maybe
think of it. That's also it. Yeah, but there was a little girl there also. Does he have a little sister also?
No, he's got the brother.
We'll get to Crescito in a minute.
No, Juanito. Yeah,
Juanito. Yeah. Oh, Juanito. Yeah. Oh. But yeah, there was a little girl there also. I was wondering if maybe that was like. Yeah, the dad, the stepdad's daughter from another marriage or something.
Yeah, perhaps she's very.
I'm gonna watch it after we're done with this. Now you got me all fired up.
You're gonna be up till 3 a.m.
Gotta wash the taste out of the brewing.
So, you know, he gets the scholarship, and then they throw a big party for him. It's the shit is lit, right? Everyone's having a good time. They're fucking dancing. They're drinking. Fucking Miklo gets his VL placa. All right. He's now down with the gang as well.
Because of the job that he did the other night against Tres Puntos, they feel like he's ready to be in the gang, finally.
Yep, so now he gets some respect.
Only thing Miklo ever wanted was to be in the gang, to be accepted by his Mexican counterparts.
And he was. Now he was.
Now he's in.
Boom. He's all in. He looks up to his big cousin there, Paco, a lot.
Big time.
Yeah, he wants to like just get his acceptance for everything. So they're dancing, they're having a great time at the party. All of a sudden, you know, there's a beautiful lady there. Cruzito puts the moves on her. Hey, let me go get my boys GTO, you know, let's go for a drive,
Chucky,
or whatever.
Let me get the keys.
Your father's GTO. And so
which they never really mentioned that Chucky is just as white as Miklo. And he's clowning on him all the time for being so pale.
He's way more Mexican looking than
he is.
So Cruzito gets the car. He gets the beautiful woman in the car. He tells her he's going to paint her like an Aztec princess. And they go to a nice spot where they can, you know, get their thing on. Yeah. And they park it. You know, he starts to get romantic up in there. All of a sudden, boom. Spider and the Tres Puntos roll up on fucking Cruzito with the girl. They take the girl. They're holding her back. They pick up Cruzito by the arms and the legs, lift him over their head, and drop him on a fucking fire hydrant.
Okay. You got to explain a little better. So they literally have him by each arm and each leg and spine first.
Yeah.
On the little weird pointy spot on the fire hydrant, and they just smash him on it.
Yeah, it's that spot where you go, what's that thing for? And they're like, oh, it's for smashing someone's spine.
Oh, okay, it's to paralyze. That is exactly what that thing is for. That's what that giant weird screw at the top of the hydrant is for.
When they drop him on that, I gotta say, your boy there, the actor of Cruzito, amazing.
Sold it great.
All right. Makes this fucking hell.
But like, Cruzito is also like, he's like 5'6".
Yeah, like, a buck 30.
Like probably. a buck 40, yeah. Just like, he's not a big guy, so like they easily just like kind of beat him up and manhandle him while they're roughing up the woman also. Like, she had nothing to do with it. So after he gets spine busted, they proceed to cut off his Vatos Locos tattoo.
They did that, didn't they?
They absolutely did. Said this VL Picasso was coming with me.
Yeah, oh Jesus Christ. Yeah, that was
and literally
bad.
They just left him in the street. It was bad. It was bad.
She goes to go comfort him, and he's like, "Ooh, don't touch me." All banged up.
He got hemmed up, man.
Bad, yeah. He got a bad, man.
So fast forward to the hospital.
He needed a bacchiotomy after that.
Immediately. Stat. Bacchiotomy.
Yeah, they all go to the hospital to, like, you know, check up on him. They're like, oh, shit, now the whole Vatos Locos crew. There's a fucking big crew here.
There's so many people in the gang that are just in the.
And I'll tell you, these guys. Flyest dressed dudes ever, right? These guys got the fucking jackets with their names on them. Vatos Locos on the chest. Chewy on the back.
Is this the first time I met Chewy?
No. Chewie's been there.
No, as far as like in other movies, the guy that plays Chewie.
This is definitely the first appearance of Chewie for us, I think.
Huh.
Because we were on this movie fairly early.
Yeah, because it was like early 90s.
I mean, he could have been like in an episode of Law and Order here and there.
Yeah, probably.
Mexican Something like thug. That. Yeah, exactly. Number two, you know. He was also in Training Day, which he was fucking frightening in Training Day.
Oh, he scared the shit out of me.
You ever shit bushed in?
But even in Breaking Bad.
Oh, you know God. What I mean? Yeah, he's fucking menacing.
Hard body, man.
This, though. You see him and you go, that's a scary motherfucker. I would not fuck with this man, right? But then his character in the movie is like, you want to hang with this guy. Yeah. You're like, this guy is the coolest guy
around.
If that
was my friend, I would ride for that dude.
Yeah, he's the coolest. You
know what I mean? Because I know he would do the same thing for me. And we'll explain that later on down the line. But yeah, I think this is the first movie I saw him in.
Incredible.
Love it.
Yeah, he's got the strap. Let's go. He pulls the fucking the shooter hospital. Out of the out of
They're
the,
in the hospital pulling out the guns. Like, what you want to do, Paco?
Let's get these vatos. He's like, no, chill. We're going to wait till the morning. And then we're going to get that ass.
And then Paco's mom comes in.
It's Sunday, I say.
Paco's mom goes, they ain't going to church, is it? Paco's mom comes in and she sees them all in the lobby all wilding out and she's like, you can't do this. Come on. This is your cousin. Come on. I know you.
Haven't enough people been hurt already?
Yeah.
You know, she gets all, you know, very momsy in there.
But mine is my family. I'm your family.
Oh my God.
I'm your family. Love it. Love it. And Miklo is like, he's so distressed. He wants to stay.
They both leave him. They break her heart.
He's like, I'm sorry. Right, you know, he's just like, I got to go. I got to go, auntie.
She knows it's going to be bad.
Got to go, auntie. You know, because it's going to go bad. And what happens?
Goes bad. They go the next morning. The fucking Tres Puntos are partying. I don't know who parties at 8 in the fucking 9
it
in
is,
the morning.
It is morning light. And they're just hanging out, drinking beers and accosting women.
Yeah. He's like, oh, I need to get laid right now, 8:30 a.m.
Okay, so there's the one scene with this, one of the Tres Puntos is with this girl like outside of the car standing around and he's like, hey, come here. And she's like, no, don't. And he just pulls her board.
Yeah.
Just like, I'm like, what? This is weird. Anywho.
This movie's very rapey.
Oh, yeah. But lurking in the shadows. Yeah.
Literally. this is going down. You know, they're having a little shindig in this on the top of this hill in the middle of Los Angeles. And
beautiful view.
Beautiful. Gorgeous.
So your boy Spider from Tres Puntos is taking a piss over the side of the hill.
The Vatos Locos.
And he's like, oh, all this is mine now.
They're creeping. Yeah, this is my city now. Fuck those Vatos Locos, you know? But what he doesn't know, unbeknownst to Spider.
Look at you.
The Vatos Locos.
Wordly wise.
Are fucking creeping through the grass like fucking like the Viet Cong, okay? Ready to fucking pounce. They're just waiting for the right time. All of a sudden, boom. These guys pop up like a fucking Jack in the Box. And they're like, hey, fucking Vatos, what's up now? Boom. Yo, big man, dude, like 6'6". I never seen a bigger Mexican in my life. Boom, pulls out the shotgun. All right, let's play.
You see a bunch of Mexicans show up in trench coats.
It's a bad day.
Trench
for you.
Coats and them hats. You know what I mean?
Yeah, those fedoras.
Those fedoras.
Man.
You're fucked, man. You did something wrong.
You fucked up.
Yo, I apologize.
Yeah, you.
I didn't know that was your cousin.
Just run, just run.
But yo, they came through deep too.
Hard body.
Deep.
With some, every dude there looked like a killer.
So they had Tres Puntos.
I don't care if they were real actors or what was going on. These guys.
They had Tres Puntos cut off every corner. Everybody was covered with a gun and
they had nowhere to go.
It was over for them.
But they could have, you know, just sprayed the whole scene, got it real nasty. But no, Paco challenges Spider one-on-one.
So yo, square
let's,
up.
Let's dance.
Square up.
I know a tune. It's called Stick and Cut.
Bang.
They pull out the knives. They start going at it. Boom. They're cutting one another, trying to cut one another. Fucking Paco kicks him to the fucking ground. Ooh, my chest. Fucking my ribs.
My ribs. Yeah, Paco.
He tries to run.
We haven't told
you
guys yet, but Paco was like junior amateur boxer.
And it's Benjamin Bratt, and he looks, he is like,
he's in great
incredible shape in this.
He looks like Lieutenant Daniels as a young Mexican man.
Oh my God. Yeah, yeah. Like I can see that.
He's in that kind of shape.
He's got the, always with the wife beater on, right? Showing off the pecs, showing always. Off the fucking, yeah, the arms.
Jealousy. But he,
it's hard to describe how suave he is in this movie too. He's the coolest guy in the room.
Not my style.
Yeah.
But it's just a shame because he was winning the fight. Everything was going great. Cut Spider up.
Beats Spider his ass, breaks the ribs.
Kicks him in the chest, falls down the big ass hill. And as he falls down the big ass hill, our boy Paco gets on top of him with a knife. And he decides to carve the letters VL for Vatos Locos in Spider's chest.
The dog is belly up. The dog is belly up.
And you would think that'd be the end of it.
That was it. He
Vatos
was like,
Vatos Locos are celebrating.
Now, oh, wait, hold on a second. Paco pulls out the pistol. Then Miklo grabs Miklo him by the hands him. And he goes, the dog is belly up. Leave him as it is. We don't need to
kill him.
He's fucked up. He's got it. You know what I mean?
Everybody's going to know.
We're square. So Miklo is being the clear-headed one here.
He's like, we don't exactly
and
right.
You could see good acting by Benjamin Bratt here. He looks up at you. Could see the chain. Boom. Oh, okay. Yeah, you got this. Okay. You're right. I don't need to fuck myself up. They go to the fucking flea.
Boom. We're out of here.
They're fucking, woo, fucking, you know, celebrating a little bit as they're running down to the whip to escape. Spider gets up, runs back to one of their whips, pulls out a gun, runs back down the hill. Now, I don't know how fast this motherfucker is after getting his ass whipped with the ribs and all that whatnot.
I think this dude had a collapsed lung, and then he just ran like Carl Lewis down to the car.
Yeah, if I had to nitpick a scene here, yeah, this is definitely one of them. He gets to the car. He pulls out the strap. Boom. He starts letting off shots off. Fucking boom. Hits Miklo like in the, I would say like the lower abdomen.
Yeah, yeah. Right above like the appendix pelvic area.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Like right above that area.
That soft spot there. Ooh, that probably hurt. Oof.
Ooh.
Like a liver shot, you know? Like, Hits him there. And now Miklo had the gun because he had taken it from Paco. It was still in his hand as they were running.
Mm-hmm.
So, boom, he hits him with the shot in the fucking...
Instinctively.
Instinctively, he turns around holding the gun and just kind of like lets a couple off. This guy has the greatest aim I've ever seen in my life.
Fucking marksman.
With like a snub-nose 38. Hits this guy like twice in the abdomen and like once in like the heart. Like just to ends this motherfucker.
38 don't jam.
But at the same time, he's like, oh, no. Like, he knows he done fucked up, and he didn't want to be a murderer.
He wasn't trying to escalate the situation more than they already had.
Exactly.
He was like, it was over.
He was being the level-headed guy. He's the one who wanted to bounce. But no, that shit didn't happen. So they get fucking Miklo in the car. They're like, we got to fucking bounce, right? And he's hurt. He's injured bad. He's bleeding. Ooh, he's all fucked up, right? They're like, yo, we got to get you in a hospital. Don't take me. Some people die there.
Don't take me to county. Don't worry. We're going to county. County? And he starts to try to jump out of the damn car while it's moving. Miklo's like, don't bring me to the hospital.
No, he's like, you need to go. You're fucked up, dude. They're whipping in this GTO through the side streets. Now the police are on the fucking.
Yo, this GTO is beat up, but I would take it today.
They're rolling. They're trying to get to the hospital, but they're fucking whipping through like the back streets of East Los Angeles.
Again, another nitpick. Don't speed.
Don't speed.
I mean, you just committed a murder. Don't speed away.
I know there's, you know, you got your man in the car. He's bleeding. There's things going on, but you got to fucking chill out a little bit.
They're doing like 70 into 35.
Easy. Whip right past the policeman. Cruising. He's like, what the fuck is this? These guys just flew through a red light. They're going.
Yeah, jumped a curb.
Yeah, they're wiling. Now the police are in fucking chase. These guys are whipping through the streets like fucking crazy people. Whipping all around. But they know the back
all
roads.
All of a sudden, they're turning the fucking Cannonball Run.
Yeah, they're all over the place. They're whipping through side streets. Like, don't worry, we know these streets. You know, fucking the old Chicano U-turn. They come through.
What you know about the Chicano U-turn? Yeah, Melo.
They fucking kind of like, they don't lose the cops, but they're in a position where they can fucking get away no problem. They roll up on Alpino as they're fucking taunting the police. They look forward. There's fucking abuela and the fucking and the kid.
There's a little. There's an old lady and a child with groceries slowly moseying through the intersection that they're about to
at Alpino. Yeah, exactly.
And so they have no choice but to abandon ship and swerve out of the way, and then they hit a tree or something.
Yeah, I think they hit one of those Jersey barriers, yeah, maybe, or something like that.
So they had to abandon ship.
So a few of the Vatos Locos bounce, but Paco stays with his cousin, which was, I think,
Miklo, I can't leave you. It was Vatos Locos forever. Old.
Yeah, it was a fucking, that was a great scene, man. He's like, yo, I'm not going
to
leave.
No, Miklo was encouraging him to go.
Yeah, he's like, go, go, go. He's like, no, Vatos Locos forever. Fucking grabs him up by the hand, goes to fucking get him out of there. But Miklo's hurt bad. He can't run. And boom, cops are like, yo, my cousin's hurt, Holmes. He needs to go to, he needs to go to the hospital. He's been shot. They're like, yo, shut the fuck up, Mexican. Get on the ground. It's bad. It's bad for everybody.
Yeah, cops are dicks.
Fucking.
And they treat them like shit, and those two get arrested. Everybody else gets away, though.
You know what I appreciate here? You don't have any court elements of this movie.
No, there's a lot of talk of court, but I don't think we ever see anybody court.
There's never a courtroom
scene.
We see
a probation situation.
Yeah.
But I don't think we ever see anybody in a courtroom.
Yeah. It's
wild.
Just, done deal. You're fucked. You know what I mean? Which is kind of amazing. So
yeah, I mean,
Miklo, I think it's hit with.
They didn't really have a dog in this fight. They were guilty.
So now Cruz is in the hospital still, banged the fuck up. You got Miklo now, who's facing, and Miklo and Cruz, who are facing charges, right? Who knows, for the murder or for
Miklo
fucking,
and Paco.
Miklo and Paco, excuse me. They're facing some bullshit.
Cruzito's just facing shit in a bag.
Yeah, for a minute.
So, yeah, they just fast forward us. They don't even give us any kind of, like, court proceedings, not like Law and Order, where
and
we see, like, part
know,
three.
You
just
see,
like, boom.
You see Miklo, boom, coming into jail. It's like, oh.
Walking off the bus. Oh, and that is such a frightening scene.
Into San Quentin, all right? Now, this was shot at San Quentin on fucking location.
I think this was, like, 78.
No. This movie was 93, right?
But I think they're like,
oh, the year he
the
was
year
coming,
and the
yeah,
time.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Because like they use different cars and like different like locations and whatnot, tried to make it look like it was older because all the time passed. So like, this is Niccolo. Spoiler alert: first time going to prison.
First time.
But him just walking through people the yard that first time,
sexually
just people
harassing
yelling.
Him?
And yes, I believe you said a lot of people look like they weren't really actors.
Yeah, no, those are a lot of fucking inmates in this movie.
They, the only actors that are in the movie are like the ones that we see outside of San Quentin. They use all prisoners.
Yeah.
And I don't think you will be able to do that ever again. I'm pretty sure that is completely illegal.
Yeah, there's something
else going
on there.
They would not trust that shit to happen, but like they got permission from people. And I believe I'm not trying to be speaking out of turn, but I think they got people permission from the Mexican mafia, particularly.
Yes, because they had
speak
made,
about a lot of these.
They
things.
Made the American Me movie before, little right before
this.
This
director, same director, right?
No, because that was Edward James Olmos who directed American Me.
Oh, really?
Yes, and he really didn't get permission from the fucking Mexican mafia.
Oh, and they pissed about it.
Yeah, they were mad pissed about it. And because of the rape scene in that, that's why in this film,
so they thought it was
there's a lot of sexual harassment, but the main character, Miklo, who is also based on one of the Mexican mafia guys who's a white Mexican, he gets sexually harassed, but he never becomes the victim of that sexual harassment. He uses it.
I mean, yeah, he's a victim.
He's definitely a victim,
like,
but not
to that extent.
Yeah, not to like the... he's a victim of sexual harassment, but not rape or sexual assault, I guess you could say, right?
Plenty of physical assault.
Yeah, plenty of physical assault. It can be quite a bit in this film. But at least there's like not really any of the... There's none of those scenes, really, where someone gets sexually assaulted brutally, like in other films, you know what I mean? Like in American Me, which is...
I'm trying to think of... Cause the,
or like, what's that one with the Shawshank?
Oh, boy. That wasn't fun. I love that movie, but it's a tough watch sometimes. I don't think I love it as much as everybody else does.
Yeah.
But I love it. I'm trying to think of the fella, Tom Hackford, I believe, was the director.
Of this movie?
Yeah. I'm trying to remember.
Oh, Taylor Hackford.
Taylor Hackford. Thank you. But what else? He did another movie in this same, like, in the same genre. Oh, you know what he directed? He did the movie just about Miklo.
Miklo.
Yeah, it came out sometime after this.
That was the documentary?
I think so.
Okay.
I never got to see it, so I can't.
It was all right. It was, you know, went into his whole thing about this film, you know, which, you know, for you or I, it's fucking.
Yo, I would amazing. I'd pay top dollar.
So Miklo gets up into prison. It's fucking scary. People are fucking harassing him. They're fucking talking mad shit. They're fucking whistling at him. There's a whole thing going on, and Miklo, because he's white on the outside and brown on the inside, it's going to be hard for him to kind of, like, just live in this motherfucking situation.
Until.
Fuck. Were you going to go take a piss or something real quick?
Yeah. Let's get a pause real quick.
All right. Well, let me play a song for you. And then,
I mean, maybe play rap music for people.
Yeah, yeah. That's a great idea.
I'm drinking all this fucking water. Trying to stay hydrated.
you gotta stay hydrated. Right,
yeah, until this happens.
Yeah, yeah. We'll hold that thought. Where are we at here? We're at him coming in, right? All right, there we go.
Miklo good and catcalled.
Yes.
Coming off the bus.
Jesus.
What you going to play for us? We can do.
Oh, I got something. Nunu? For you. Darn it. You're going to the bathroom.
Oh, darn it. I'm going darn quick.
It. Yeah, 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 go talk quick. I'm going to play this Domogenesis and The Alchemist. I'm not sure if you heard this one yet, Birdman. Featuring Smoke Dizza. Really dope track here. This one kind of caught me off guard last week. But Domogenesis and The Alchemist got a new album together. And this shit's dope. I mean, Jesus, there's a lot of stuff going on right now with The Alchemist. He's crazy. Crazy. Like Jelani said earlier, he was listening to that new Larry June. If you haven't peeped that, do that. The Alchemist had one with Benny the Butcher as well. That Sandcastles joint, I think, pretty recently. There's a lot going on with The Alchemist. A lot going on. He's really good. Let me give this one a play. And Jelani will be back in a moment.
Money talks, so shut the fuck up and listen. You fucking kids in intermission, I'm in pole position, and you're in no position. I'm itching to close and in it, zone and kill it, close conceal it, leave that bitch with no forensics. Bitch, it's not a stain on me, lil' homie. You don't know me, better know you rode your brony, lil' phony. Trying to clone me, I'm my only, like I'm Kobe in the post, you can't control me. Spitting scriptures, niggas feel like I'm holy, niggas know he bound to be a problem in this rap shit. I snap, bitch, my stats went from average to classic with hand-mended damage. Your man's a get sandwiched. My plan is the planet where the middle of my hand is. Alpha male, you niggas do what you manage. I'm cheering for the stars, really feeling like I can't miss. My flow is Australian money, bro, you can't rip. Keep it live, smoking, getting high until I'm dead, bitch. Right. Kush Garden, this motherfucker. Right, I smoke the whole jar like, oh lord, au revoir. Girl Scout cookie and not them little hoes, y'all. Talking at West Coast, I got it from my homeboy. I hate green weed like Google fans hate solar. Got no respect for it like a grown man with a mohawk or a big mouth with no heart or a black bitch with a nose job. Just some shit I don't go for. I don't really give a fuck about offending, just my opinion. Ill nigga, full of Philippe Chow when I'm bitten. Trying to gas this Asian bra for a BJ and a happy ending. Still pitching like I'm in the ninth inning. I'm a closer. I'm Mariano with the flow, bruh. See me suited, five panels with the beers on them. Every bar they Ric Flair for them. Dizza.
Thank you.
top of squares on the bed. We work for God, fixed salary. Got the dope sense stuck in the walls. New York goggles. When the bag of dope, a reek in the creed. The gold bottle, drink the gold bottles. Gun on my head. I'm not a role model. Bullets in the air. I make my flow follow. I was a model in Tulum. Caught him in the shower. Beat him with a mop. Choppers in the locker room. He's doing operations. Niggas left his zippers. I'm in the X7. Whole neck glitter. A cold world. Make the tech shiver. Don't contest that. I be at where you rest at. So many chains on. Bitches asking where my neck where at. The bin on the protect black. My nigga blue drab. Heard he got max in the supermax. Word is and diesel like Luga. Turn 1 to 3 and yell hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to see the king.
Made a brick through yoga. I know my heart white and I'm ex-con flights. The Oklahoma, a pale heart. I'm Dale Earnhardt with a smoking motor. Black Sopranos, I took the O for La Costa Nostra. Did it my way. I got the most of these coaching vultures. You gotta pay me what you owe. But nope, I won't consult you. I did more numbers with half your budget. I hope it woke you. I put a brick on my block in a yacht in an open ocean. A felon, I've been convicted. Irrelevant what I'm spending. But what matter is, I'm doing better than what's predicted. Should've got a Grammy now, but fuck it. Cause Royce and Freddie family ties. Frank Lucas video, the Miami vibe. This life crazy, every minute someone recording you. They ask me if I feel famous now. Nigga, of course I do. Corporate moves, my office and my business resources group. Took the long road, you niggas looking for shortcuts through. Expose who, nigga, I'm hood as a gold tooth. Hold two joints in a whip when I roll through the toll booth. I heard the albums niggas just put out in old cute. But I'm the best, TT3, BOP, those proof.
Love, nigga. Jordan Pack 5's gun metal. Sun special, used to serve gate. Wordplay on big fun level. Smoke come out the barrel when the gun settle. Know some gangsters in Arizona playing the field like the sun devil. I put some diamonds in Hun Bezel and them yellow. I got a shooter in New York, I call him Young Mellow. I got some rope in a trunk, tape and one shovel. Long money, talking billions, nigga, and I want several. Ain't worried about them niggas, all them niggas puss. Niggas dig Ryan rap, it's real hard to get a look. I used to hustle on Doe Street, the carbon in the bush. Bagging up at the Sphinx house, she shooting doggy in her foot. I bought some water, watch how saucy niggas look. Sneak this, the same niggas used to call me for a hook, right? I thought these niggas crooks, why all these niggas shook? Griselda, you took shit over, like, how long it really took? Look, my city is the wildest, I know niggas up in Hollis. Spin a yard, pull up bar, biggest nigga dollar. And lately I've been getting bigger dollars, talking digits with the commas. If it's smoke, we spin it, bitch, I promise. Look, ducking and hiding only gets you bigger problems. Cause if it takes too long to find you, then we visiting your mama, nigga. Yeah. I know them killers up in Dallas. Street nigga for real, boy, my trigger finger collars. I see they pictures, them niggas need a stylist. People riding my dick, leaving opinions in my comments, nigga. I get my chef on, any career I step on. The fuck I look like putting a dress on? Fucking crazy, nigga. The same, bitch. Out your fucking mind, nigga.
Boom.
Yo, tell the people what those songs were one more again.
That was Domo Genesis and The Alchemist featuring Smoke Dizza, the power ballad.
Dope.
Fucking fire, right?
Dope.
What did he say about it? He goes, like Guru Flante's Solar or some shit like that.
Oh, that resonates so hard in my veins. Only problem I had with that one is one of them mentioned something about eating a happy ending from a masseuse. And right now, you know about that dude on
Beef? Yeah, yeah, David Cho. Yeah, I listened to that episode actually back because I used to listen to that DVD ASA.
Oh, and you were just fine with it?
No, I wasn't fine with it. Yeah, I stopped listening to it after that. I think actually it stopped coming out after that.
But is that when this popped up and I saw the clip and it was like somebody Akira, I was like, wait a minute.
She's a porn star.
That ain't who I think it is.
That's who you think it is.
That's who I think it is.
Yeah.
They had a show together?
They had a show together. It was hilarious. It was a funny show.
What was it like, dude?
They just talked just about dumb shit the whole time, and they just be cracking weird jokes. Yeah. Talking about life and bullshit.
Yeah, and raping people.
Yeah. I mean, it's kind of like how what they do with Bobby Lee. You know what I mean? Like that type of podcast. You know what I mean? It's that type of shit.
I don't know. Bobby Lee, the comedian.
Yeah, where he just says crazy shit. Like he was like, you know what? Like a couple weeks ago, he was like, you know what you'll never see in Korea? Slaves. And they're like, yo, Bobby Lee. and they start sending them all these facts about slavery in Korea and how it's been going on for like thousands and thousands of years and is still very active today. And he's like, oh shit, you know, like he says dumb shit, you know, quite funny. But anyways, the other one was Hell on Earth, West Side Gun, featuring Benny and Conway there.
And what is that off of?
That one was off of, I'll tell you right now, but
I liked it, them both.
That's off the Hermes 8 side B.
Okay. Wait, side B?
Yeah. That's some Spotify shit. I don't know.
Is that a different project?
I don't know.
The Hermes 8?
I'm not quite sure. Stove God Cooks on here with AZ, the 99 Avrex, Rome Street, Stove God. There's a lot of, maybe it's the same. I don't know.
I think 8 might have been the best out of that collection. I don't know.
That's the one with 2 Chainz. Chase Fetty's on here. Remember we
yeah, yeah. Back on when, we liked it that.
Yeah.
Chase Fetty did an album with Currency also not long ago.
Really?
Dope.
That's good stuff. All right, so getting back to
let me double check that. Somebody we love, he did an album with, and it was like too short because it was so good that it was like, I need about 30 more minutes of that.
So Miklo gets in the prison. He's not quite sure what the fuck is going down here, right? So he's rolling through and people try to harass him. And he's like, yo, I'm like this, I guess you could say a transgendered man rolls up on him, right? And is like, yo,
you look weird.
Yeah, you yeah, like he says some weird shit to him. And this dude, Miklo, thinks he's like hard body, right? So he's like, yo, I'm just going to fucking smack this fool. And that doesn't happen because this dude's a large guy, right?
It's a tall fella.
Tall woman or whoever we want to say, a tall person. They grab the hand out of the midair, and he's like, yo, this dude's about to lay the smack down, and all of a sudden, a brown hand comes out of nowhere and just grabs dude by the hand, and you see the VL tattoo on his hand, and he's like, yo,
Picasso.
Hey, Bo Peep.
Hey, little Bo Peep.
Hey, Cinderella, go find yourself a fella. I think that's what he says, right?
Would you get that Picasso?
Yeah, ask him where he gets the tattoo, and he's like, yo, I got it from my, you know, my cousin, Cruzito, and he's like, oh. Now, was Chewy his nephew or something like that? Chewy? He's my carnal.
He was his cousin or something.
Yeah.
They were so definitely family. He's like, oh, Chewy? Chewy's my carnal.
Yeah, so they're kind of, Miklo thinks he's in tight with this dude, Popeye, right?
This Popeye dude, Cerveta.
Amazing, right? This guy, who's your favorite character in this movie? I think we should get to it now. Why not?
We should get to it now while you're in the middle of telling the story?
In the middle of it. I just got to.
My favorite character is Magic.
Magic? He's that dude, huh?
Magico.
Los Puntos. Spider.
He's a soldier. Like, I think in The Wire, I think Bodhi is my favorite character because he just was what he was. He was a soldier from the first moment you saw him to the last moment you saw him. Just
ride or die.
Yeah. Exactly. Like Slim Charles said, even if it's a lie, you got to fight on that lie. Another soldier.
Yeah.
Like Slim Charles is like up there with me too. Like people that crept up out of nowhere.
So Popeye kind of takes, you know, Miklo. He's like, okay, I'll show you around. You know what I mean? Show you what's going on. So he walks him through the prison. And he's like pointing people out. Like, okay, this is kind of weird to me. Like, oh, yeah, that's the leader of the fuck. You know, he's, like, pointing out these, like, type of people. He's like,
yeah,
over here is the...
Apparently, it's an open secret.
Yeah. Over here is the Mexican... Oh, thank
double
you.
Double time. Thank you so much.
Double tap.
Please, take the largest dab you can. Please. That is amazing.
So he's showing him around. He's like, yo, this is the Mexican gang over here. Here's the fucking... The white Aryan gang. Here's the BGA. This is the black gang. And he basically, he runs down the whole spot. So now you're privy to what's going down. Tells you what's their running.
The Aryan Vanguard.
The Aryan Vanguard. That's the AVers.
The AVers.
Jesus Christ.
And then the BGA.
The Black Guerrilla Army.
The Black Guerrilla Army. And was that the only one aside from the La Onda?
Yeah, and La Onda. Yeah, so it's the three gangs. La Onda
was like the Mexicans.
Yes. And it's led by Bonafide, the Black Guerrilla Army, the BGA.
Played by Delroy Lindo.
Yep. the Aryan Vanguards led by Red Ryder, who I think he's like kind of a that guy. You know what I mean? Like,
what else do you know him from?
I feel like I've seen him in something else, but he's a bad motherfucker. This guy,
yeah, I'm going to find him. I'm going to let
find
you
this
know.
Dude. Yeah. Red Ryder. Red Ryder.
And you see him and he's fucking pumping weights.
Yeah. He's fucking deep. fucking the fucking sunglasses on. Man.
And as he's going crazy, lifting weights, you see that one of the guys spotting him is, Billy Bob Thornton.
A very young Billy Bob Thornton, playing one of his earliest movies,
playing a Nazi. Also, he's got the SS tattooed on his
the
neck.
The swastika is on his neck, and yeah, and SS tattoos. He's a real fucking scumbag in this. Go deep.
Wild stuff.
Shows him all around. He's like, "Yo, how can I get down with the gang?" No, and he doesn't know that. Actually, comes a little later. He finds that out real
but
quick.
But when they run into the AVers, there's a problem with people not paying.
Right.
We learn that there's a relationship business-wise with Popeye.
Find out the AVers are running the books or something like that, like the gambling in the prison.
And Popeye owes them money, so they don't really like respect him like that.
Yeah, they fucking treat him like shit and whatnot. He's kind of a dickhead.
They're very disrespectful to him. Let me just say that.
And in before the previous to that, he was coming off like he was like the man and shit in there. You know what I mean? And they're like, "Yo, fuck you," you know.
Billy Bob Thornton's name was Lightning, right?
Lightning, Lightning.
Go on, Lightning.
This is my coon dog. Get them coons. Arf, 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 arf. Fucking crazy, man.
This is one of those racist movies I think I've ever seen in my entire life, but in all directions. Everyone is racist. Everyone and is actually kind of startling.
So he shows him around. And he's like, you know, kind of like it feels like he's gonna take Miklo under his wing, and he's like taking him back to his cell. He's like, "Yeah, man, I got your back. You know, here's some cigarettes." He's like, "Yo, I don't smoke." He's like, "Yo, don't worry about it. You can use it for trade and shit. You know what I mean? I got your back, homie." They go into the cell, and all of a sudden, boom. Popeye fucking shoves this dude right in the fucking corner of the fucking cell, like smacks his fucking head off the toilet.
You're startling.
Like, you're like, what the fuck has happened? Because like you're like kind of in. You're like, oh yeah, these guys are homies now. You know what I mean? They're family. They're Vatos Locos, right?
I'm like, oh, Miklo's going to be okay.
No. He's going to be all right. No.
You thought?
And then boom, all of a sudden this dude's like, yo. He's so menacing looking. He's giving like the finger, right? Like I'm holding the hand out and I'm doing the two finger come to me.
Yeah.
And he's like, give me some chon chon. You know, he's like, you want me to take it? You want me to rape you? And you're just like, I was aghast when I first seen it. I was like, yo, is this really happening right now? This is about to be some shit. But Miklo's crafty, right? This dude goes in for it, right? And he fucking, boom, hits him with the elbow. You know, they're about to get into it, but fucking... Great elbow shot. But Popeye's got, I think, a shiv with him. You know what I mean?
That's when he pulls it out. After he got hit in the mush.
I'm going
to
take it.
You want me to take it, huh? Yeah. Scariest moment, I think, thus far in the movie.
Yeah, really fucking... Just a menacing scene. Then all of a sudden, where you think it's about to go down, boom. The fucking Mexican mafia rolls up. The Leonda fucking rolls up behind him and is like, yo... Chill. We don't fucking do that shit.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? We don't fucking rape people up in here. You know what I mean? Or whatever, right? They're very, they got some like, yo, that's low class.
Chewy ain't got no class.
Like, but Popeye ain't got no class, homie.
So it's Montana, and I can't remember his boy's name. I should look it up. Like his right hand man. But they show up with like proper decorum. You know what I mean? They're just like, yo, chill. Stop. They shut it down quick. Like, stop all this right now. This doesn't happen on my tier.
Yep. And he's like, fucking, okay, Miklo saves the day. And then Miklo's like, okay, that must be the man over there. And kind of gives him, like, the heads up.
Damn. I don't know Montana's right-hand man's name.
Neither do I.
He is so
he's
vital.
He's got the slick back hair. I think that's a real ass dude. I don't think that's a fucking actor.
He is
right
so
there.
Vital to the whole movie. How have I never even... learned what that man's name is. I feel like a failure.
It's all right. We still love you. So he's like, Miklo feels like he owes him to the guy something. So he kind of like, he goes to the talk to the guy, and they're like, yo, fuck you, fucking gringo, get the fuck out of here. And he's like, yo, he's about to bounce, and he's like, yo, send him in. And he goes in there, and he talks to the fucking the head of the fucking Mexican mafia, and he's like, yo, you know, can I be down with your shit, kind of? And he's like, yo, you're fucking white, man, basically, right? And he's like, yo, if you gotta, you're going to have to do something real fucking serious to get up in this fucking shit. Right?
Okay, yeah, I think you're skipping some stuff, but that's fine.
Am I? Well, yeah. Just a little bit. I'm going to get to it because, you know, that's going to be a whole storyline there. So he basically tells him, like, yo, you're going to have to do some real serious shit, you know what I mean, to fucking get up in this, you know what I mean? So meanwhile, during all this, Miklo's being sexually harassed by a fucking white dude.
Because you're missing a huge scene.
Which one am I missing?
Where Montana, where like Miklo.
I
like,
don't want his pork chop.
Thank you. That's a big scene.
No, he sees him first in the cell first, and then they go down, and then they go back.
I don't think so.
No?
No. I think the in the cell is later on.
After that? After the pork chop?
Yeah.
All right, so.
Because Magic hangs him over the railing. Before that.
That's right. Go ahead, drum me.
I love that movie, man. You kidding me? I should have taken the fucking. I got a picture of three of the boys hanging up in my house from Blood In, Blood Out. And when people see it, if they get it, then they we're like the really friends.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
exactly.
People just seem like, what's that? And I'm like, yeah. I'll explain it to them. You know, it's not a big deal, but, you know, if you see it and you know, you're one of us.
Exactly. So, yeah. Miklo's being kind of sexually harassed by this white dude. He's part of the Aryan gang. He's the skeeviest, dirtiest scumbag you've ever seen in your life, fucking Big Al. And he's always up in Miklo's shit, and he's, like, calling him to the front of the line to give him extra food and shit. And this kind of makes the other fucking inmates pissed off, right? And he also holds up time because he doesn't want, you know, anything for free. But at the same time, he's got no choice. So this dude wants Miklo bad, right? He wants to take it.
Oh yeah. He wants to go full.
And Miklo, to be like, now, Miklo gets the last pork chop. In the dining hall, right? Because and he gets double pork chops, so
it's a whole scene.
It's a whole scene. Whole
Miklo's holding up the line. He got to get thrown in. Sure. And all of a sudden, as Vega said, Miklo gets the last pork chop in the whole lunchroom.
So he goes to sit down, and people are pissed. He's like, "I want my fucking chop, your boy Magic, right? I only get chopped once a year." Want my fucking chop.
Justifiably so.
And then this dude starts fucking yelling some racial obscenities, like fucking on some wild shit. Everyone's pissed, right? Everyone goes to sit down. Miklo comes out the cut. I don't know if it's like a cowardly thing or if it's a fucking smart play by him.
No. So, okay. I'm jumping in. All right.
Yeah.
So Montana and Magic are like the next two people in line.
Yes.
For the
They're right behind
room.
Miklo.
So this dude stops the line
to call him
to
up
call
from-
Miklo up from the front. He's way in the back and gives him the last. It is the biggest pork chop that I've ever seen them. Like, they've shown us him, like, give people
two
meat
pork
the
chops.
Whole
so
time,
it would have been,
you know,
Montana's,
I mean,
pork chop and Magic's pork chop.
It's like, it's a big old juicy pork chop. And, like, the past, like, five we've seen him give people have been, like, fucking just fat.
Yeah, dog
just like
shit.
Grilled fat, nothing. But Miklo gets,
hey, there's no meat on this chop.
He gives him an apple too, you know what I mean? He gives him a little extra. And after that, he tells Montana and them, no more meat. And so Miklo comes over afterwards to be like, hey, I'm sorry. I thought you wanted my chop.
Yeah, he tries to give him
his food. He's like, I'm sorry. I didn't mean for that to happen, essentially. Is what he meant by it, but like he gets all roughed up.
And Montana doesn't take the chop. He says, I don't want his pork chop. And he snags fucking homeboy's apple, or he has an apple.
He takes the apple off the tray.
Yeah, he takes the apple off the tray and he squeezes the apple. And he's like, I want his life. And then
Twitch magic quickly snatches that pork chop. And
yeah, starts eating like a fucking animal.
Hands. He's like, fuck it, I'm taking that. Oh, that's my favorite. That might be one of my favorite scenes of the movie.
That's a solid one. It's a solid one.
I don't want his pork chop.
I want his life.
I want his life. And so that's how then Biklo goes to see him. And then magic hangs him over the thing. And
then they speak and he's like, yo, listen, I want to be down. And he's like, yo, you're going to have to do some real fucking crazy shit. You're going to do some real crazy shit. You're fucking, because you're fucking white. You know what I mean? To get the respect of these guys. And he's like, use my white skin. You know what I mean? He's like, you know, I can use that to fucking get up on these.
I'm glad you're Mexican, so I'm not going to get a lot of.
Use my white skin. So they, he's like, fuck yeah. They're going to use his skin, right? So he starts playing the fucking, this game with the Big Al guy, right? Kind of flirting with the Big Al character. And as he's doing this, he can see that Big Al is the person who runs the books, right? And there's always, there's cash around, but that's not even the thing. He just wants to kill Big Al. That's the whole point of this whole scenario of him flirting with Big Al and kind of leading him on that essentially, you know, eventually that Big Al's going to get a taste of his pie.
But seeing, you know, he's behind the curtain in the Wizard of Oz, you know what I mean? He sees how it's actually really running.
Yeah.
He's like, oh, wait, this dude's in on too?
Yeah, yeah. So he's like, oh.
One of the prison guards?
There's a prison guard there. There's a lot of shit going down. And he's just kind of being like, just in the background. And he's wondering why, there's people there that are wondering, like, why are you always bringing this, you know, fucking little kid around or whatever, you know, and get pieces of ass on your own time or whatever. But Miklo escalates the whole situation. It's like, finally, he's like, I'm going to give it up to you. Let's do this now. And, you know, Miklo gets on his hands and knees and he's ready to blow this guy's horn.
We don't need to get in all this, you know.
Yep. This guy's ready. He's like, you know, close your eyes. It's going to fucking be great. All of a sudden, fucking Miklo pulls out the ice pick and just starts fucking jabbing this guy right in the chest. Just bang, 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 bang. Bangs him out right there. Dead. Big Al's gone. But while Big Al's gone, there's a ton of bread and the fucking books of everyone's name, what everyone's bed is. So he snags all the money. Fucking the books, and then he brings it back to the leader of the Mexican gang. Now, Miklo is not only down, but he's in the inner circle of the Mexican mafia. He's immediately just like, boom, shot to the top of the fucking ranks here. He went from a nobody to a somebody.
Well, that's a big get right there.
Big, big get. I mean, because now they're running the whole fucking gambling.
You got dirt on everybody now.
Yep. So you can blackmail people. You can do all this crazy shit.
Sure. Something happens to me, then this is going to happen to you. Oh, man.
You can make deals.
Such a big move. Miklo came through hard. Sorry, pause.
Yeah.
But he didn't. He didn't. He didn't. He didn't actually, like, actually do anything. He just got big. Do you think?
Yeah.
I've wondered for a long time. Big Gay Al from South Park. Is that based off of Al from Blood In, Blood Out?
No, I don't think so. Because he wasn't like, I don't think, you know, he was like a Fleece Johnson type of character. You know what I mean? Like, he just, I'm not gay. I'm just a booty warrior. I need it. And I want it.
Mm.
You know what I mean? I think he's one of those guys.
Mm.
I think they call them the undercover. They're gay in prison, but when they come out, they're, you know.
Oh, yeah. What are you talking about?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know. That was just some bussy.
Yeah, some bussy. It was, you know, it was, you know, I had to do what I had to do, you know, some bussy. So now Miklo's the man. He's in there for a minute, all right? We're just going to jump ahead.
They're
here,
fast
right?
forwarding now after this. It's like now, the show is like 4 years later, and they're showing
while
us
this
the
is
books.
Happening,
they're showing us how much money they're making. And
there's a lot going on.
How much notoriety they get in the prison. Now the Vatos Locos are taking over. Now boom. They're like in charge.
All right. And then also, while this is going down, Paco joins the Marines, gets out of the Marines, and then becomes part of the LAPD. Becomes a detective for the LAPD. The other cousin, Cruzito, is
Gets out of the hospital.
Gets out of the hospital, but he's fucked up. He's walking with a cane, and he's taking pills, and then later that parlays into a drug addiction. And then he's doing crazy art while he's addicted to drugs, still living in East Los Angeles.
Yeah, he's still trying to make a career as an artist, but the paintings are getting darker.
They're getting very dark. Miklo's in prison, like you said, like Jelani said. Fast forward, Miklo gets out of prison. He gets paroled after 9 years. He's doing good, right? When he gets out, he...
Before that happens, can I give you real quick?
Yeah.
Before they show us a scene of Paco doing undercover work.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the selling PCP, looking to buy PCP. And it is one of the creepiest fucking... This guy's got a fake fucking...
I'm guessing PCP beard. Was very prevalent at that time.
Oh, yeah, especially in that part of California. Area. Yeah, exactly. In East Los Angeles, it was very, very big.
Because this lady had a whole-ass house that...
Jars of PCP. She fucking throws... Paco looks like Jesus, right? Like Mexican like, Jesus.
He looks like Jesus.
Yeah, it's he's fucking incredible. Yeah, he tries to they basically show that he's a fucking big time. Also, his partner is Biff from fucking Back to the Future. Let's not forget this.
If you've never seen this movie and you just heard that and you don't want to see it, we're not going to be friends.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't want to shake your hand.
No, we don't fuck with you. We don't fuck with you like that.
Biff from Back to the Future is his partner in this movie.
Oh. Ring Rhames is in this movie as a top cop at the prison. Like, there's a lot going on here. The warden in the film is actually the warden of San Quentin.
It was a real dude. And I just seen here the guy that plays Ryder.
Yeah, Ryder.
We recognize him because he was like the sheriff guy in Devil's Rejects.
No shit. Same dude, just a little bit more swole,
that's all. Yeah, we know him well.
You know Rob Zombie saw this shit. He was like, yeah, I want that guy in this movie.
Oh, yeah, he must have been, I think he was in House of a Thousand Corpses first.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Miklo gets out. Things are going not good, right? He gets a job at this like shitty like fucking factory job.
Took Miklo a minute to get out.
Took me 9 years he did.
And Montana had to keep telling him, listen, you got to stick with it. You got to do the right things. You got to show them that you're going to be a better citizen.
Makes him a better person.
He's like, yo, I can't get out. So you got to do it for me.
Yep.
I got a daughter at home. I can't see her. You got to do better. So it helps him. Miklo finally gets out.
Inspires him. Miklo gets out, he gets a job, he gets a place. The only problem is the place he gets is with other gang members. Popeye is there, the guy that tried to rape him, although he kind of holds a grudge on Miklo ever since then, because also there's multiple times in prison where he got fucking punked by Miklo after the fact.
After Miklo made that big move, Miklo had better notoriety than Popeye.
Yeah, way better. Way better.
So he can punk him.
Popeye's low class.
Yeah. So he punked him a lot.
And so
even when he came out, he's like, you still owe me them bets from But Popeye's running this joint and there's like four people already living in this place, supposed to only be like three people. And like now Miklo's the fifth. He's like, do I get a bet?
Yeah, it has no bed. Yeah, I mean, his first impression of coming into the house, he gets a gun pulled on him, does he not?
Immediately.
Boom, right into his grill. And he's like, yo, what the fuck? I live here, bitch. Like, what are we doing here? And there's
That's a little later. The first thing he gets.
The big party, right?
Popeye opens the door and he's just got his underwear on.
I have red underwear.
See that big ass tattoo on his titty where it's some ruka.
Yeah,
naked. And, it looks like her bosom is his titty. It's perfect. It is the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. I'm not a tattoo guy, but if I got one, it'd be something just like that.
That same one?
That one or the Pete and Pete tattoo.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Incredible. Yeah, so he gets in there. He already knows it's a bad situation, but Miklo tries to work hard. He goes and visits the family. You know, he's talking to Cruzito. He's talking to fucking, Paco. Benjamin Bratt there. you know, he couldn't believe he's a cop, but yeah, you know, he's like, whatever, you know, you're my cousin, wow. You know, whatever.
That's,
you know?
That's so surprising that you're now a cop when you used to be the biggest gang leader this side of East Los Angeles.
Yeah, you were the baddest dude around.
Okay.
He's like, whatever, but he's still looking, Miklo the whole time is still looking for that respect from him. You know what I mean? Like, everything he does, I feel like, is for Paco. You know what I mean? Like, just to prove that he's the fucking man kind of deal, even though he'll never be as cool as Paco.
Yeah. Yeah, Miklo always looked up to him.
Yeah. But Miklo, while he's on the up and up, he just can't catch a break. He's working at this shitty factory, and the factory's ripping him off because this guy's got the boss has got a gambling problem.
One of the biggest scumbag characters ever to be in a movie.
Dirtbag.
His boss at the tire factory.
He's like, yo, what's up with my fucking paycheck, bro? He's like, this shit's short. He goes, well.
Hold up, real quick.
Yeah.
So Miklo and them used to run the numbers in San Quentin, right?
Miklo's good at math.
He's good at the numbers, right? So he overhears the guy talking about a game. You know, they're in California, so it's like Golden State and somebody and getting 4 points or something. And Miklo's just grabbing his check, and he overhears it, and he's just like, hey, listen, somebody's out. He heard his hand is not going to play. Da, da, da.
Craig, he gets him the tip.
He's
knows.
Like, hey, I don't know about that one. And the guy looks at him, doesn't say anything, then goes back to the phone and goes, yeah, double it or whatever. Like, so, yeah, like, yeah, you know,
it goes
what I mean?
Against
he's
Miklo.
Just like, fuck
like,
you. He just like looks at Miklo, is like, yeah, whatever. Stick to tires, buddy. Next day, they read the paper or the next week, whatever. And it's just like his team got crushed. Guy lost the bet.
He was right. Dude's hand is hurt. You know what
so,
I mean?
So now all of a sudden, Miklo, next week, his check is down like $80.
And he's getting paid nothing anyway.
He's getting paid like $120 a week. So yeah, he's like, wait a minute, what's going on, Jerry?
Hey, Jerry.
It's like, well.
Hey Jerry,
I took
what's
it out
going
of your
on?
Check because I'm going to do that for all the money that you stole out of the blah, blah, blah. He was like, yeah, you were the only one that had access to this register or whatever, and you're the only one that has the key, so I'm going to do this.
You know, I could call your parole officer.
Do it
you know?
Seven more times to make up all the money, and it's just like, you know, he did the math. Miklo was just about to walk out. He's like, yeah, I'll call your parole officer. Yeah. It's like, and Miklo did the math real quick. It's like, yo, seven times, that's $1,200, right? That's the money you lost on that bet? You're gonna make me
gonna
pay
off
your
gambling debts?
Oh, that was acting right there.
He went to 11 right there. You're gonna make me pay off your gambling debts?
The overacting award of the evening goes
Jesus
to
Jesus Christ.
Miklo.
Yeah, he went all in out there.
But it was great. Oh, I'll never forget it. So, yeah, the guy is strong-arming him, but he has no choice, dude. What's he going to do?
But what can he do?
Can't fight the system. So Miklo is got his back against the wall. He's getting robbed by his employer. He can't live where he's living.
Yeah, it's a bad situation.
He's doing bad, bad, bad. Now, so
within
now
the house,
their scheming comes up.
They're scheming and scamming within the house. They're gonna do fucking a robbery. Okay,
about to go down.
Miklo, Miklo didn't want any part of it. He knew it was gonna be bad news. Miklo's very, very intelligent, very street smart, right? But he comes in, he hears the plan, he's like, "Yo, fuck your plan. I'm coming in on this." And then, boom, he takes over the whole fucking shindig here, right? Kicks Popeye out of the fucking group and was like, yo, go fuck yourself. We're going to go do this fucking job, right? We're going to get some money.
And what does Popeye do?
Popeye fucking rats on him. Hey, you like busting dope dealers? He drops the fucking dime on fucking Miklo.
Hey, I'm eating lunch here.
He doesn't. He drops a dime on Miklo.
Big
now
deal
he,
going down at Whittier.
Yeah, he makes it seem like there's going to be a drug deal going down, but it's not really a drug deal because fucking Miklo and his homies, they have a guy on the inside that they're going to rob an armored truck. Now, the guy on the in, they're supposed to come in, grab the money,
boom,
roll
boom.
Out.
No
supposed
problem.
To be very
Nobody
easy.
Nobody gets hurt. Boom, boom.
Now, all of a sudden, I guess, I don't know what's going on, but nothing goes right. There's shots fired from the fucking, the goddamn armored truck. People are shooting back and forth. Boom, people are stealing money. People are going down. The cops see it. They go, oh, it's not a goddamn drug deal. It's a heist. They come out. They start fucking with their guns fucking raised and ready to go. Biff and fucking Paco here. And all of a sudden, they're like, yo, stop or we're going to shoot. Miklo turns around, pulls off his mask. He sees his cousin there, and he's like, yo, bitch, you owe me for this one. I'm going to roll the fuck out. I'm out of here. Yo, don't shoot me, copper. You know what I mean?
On some bullshit. That charge for you, baby.
Yeah, he's like, come on. So he rolls the fuck out, and he thinks he's in the clear. But no, his fucking scumbag cousin.
Stop, police.
Stop, police. I'll shoot. He fucking aims the gun, but he goes from like a back shot, and then you see him aim it low. Boom. Next thing you know, Miklo's back in prison, and he's got fucking one leg. He's walking with a peg leg, go deep. Now he's back in prison, and he's still.
Paco comes to see him in the hospital.
You took my leg! You're dead to me.
We stopped being family when you took my leg.
Yeah.
Oh my God, man.
It hurts you, man.
It was like, for real, though. You did wrong. I don't know how long we're talking about this, but we haven't mentioned yet that Danny Trejo was in this.
I'm still
trying to figure out if he was an actor or if he was, he was in still prison in. He at was the time. But yeah, Danny Trejo, 3-time boxing champ.
He's the man. Jeez, it's getting late, Jelani, and I got a long ride home.
Yeah,
we should do a part two next week. We stop here.
Yo, if you want to. Where are we? Miklo going back to prison?
Miklo's going back to prison.
Like, this is a good place to stop.
Going back to prison.
Literally,
with one leg.
Oh, my goodness.
This guy.
We're gonna come back, and we're going to start talking from the robbery.
Yeah.
We'll pick it up from there, and we'll keep it moving.
Yeah. We'll come back to the robbery a little bit. You know,
this has been my favorite podcast episode of ever.
Amazing, right? Great idea. Happy 30th anniversary to our favorite movie, Blood In, Blood Out. If you haven't seen
it. No disrespect to any Mexican people in our community. I have nothing but respect for you, and I love you, and black and brown pride forever.
What'd they say the movie? Blacks killing blacks is what they want. Blacks killing blacks.
Montana, he was all about that unity. We'll get into that.
He was. All right, gang. We'll check you next time. TheCryptOnline.com, HipHopHeads Podcast.
Maybe we'll play rap music.
Tell your friends. Yeah, maybe we'll next time.
Boom. Love you guys.
What I'd like to do is to present this evening some of the sounds that you hear from the East Coast of the United States.